right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Joe Bleakley, the CEO and founder of Pacific Frontier Investments. And Joe, it's nice to see you. How are you?
Doing great, Steve. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, really interesting company that you've put together. Tell me a little bit about this company.
Sure. So Pacific Frontier is a Canadian company. We're taking a foothold in the RV park and campground space in Canada. We're focusing in British Columbia to start. We're creating a brand of family-friendly camp resorts. We have currently one property that we've acquired. It's under construction. We have a couple more properties that we're acquiring in the very near future. And we're really going after the family-focused, family-friendly camp resort style, more of a premier offering than what you'll see out there.
So what will those campsites kind of consist of? And are you looking at older sites and then improving them as well?
Yeah. So we've got a couple different strategies. One of them is to acquire older properties that need to be upgraded. A lot of what we see is the electrical mainly needs to be upgraded. A lot of the old campgrounds have 15 amp power. And today's modern RVs require 50 amp power. They all have, a lot of them have washers, dryers, dishwashers, and the power requirements have improved significantly. But we're creating a resort style experience as well. So not only will we have 50 amp power of all of our sites, we're gonna have a swimming pool, a playground, Wi-Fi, a store. Kind of people have the option to stay on site for most of their needs is the goal that we're creating.
Right. What kind of market size are we talking about here? I mean, we obviously see a big increase in camping this year during COVID, but I would imagine that's probably going to continue. How big is the market?
Sure. So in Canada, and this is pre-COVID numbers, it was a $5 billion market. And everybody's aware of what's happened this year, people rethinking the way that they travel, not necessarily wanting to jump on a plane or go to Hawaii. A lot of people went out and bought RVs. I heard an interesting stat that there are 5 RVs for every RV spot in North America. And that was pre-COVID numbers. We've seen record numbers of RV sales this year. And now we've seen record numbers of backlogs reported by RV manufacturers. So the trend is forecasted to continue. And we think the industry that was already under tremendous pressure, having campsites chronically overbooked and hard to get, is going to be under even more pressure in the years to come.
Now, Joe, I understand that you're currently out raising capital as well. How much are you looking to raise, and will that be to grow the campsites, or what is it that you'll be using the capital for?
Yeah, great question. We've got an offering right now where we're looking for $4.9 million. We're offering a common share at 7 cents, and that money is going directly towards the acquisition and improvement costs on the additional 2 locations. The goal is to create a national brand. We're not just going after 3 campgrounds. We're going to start with 3, and then we look to acquire 2 additional properties per year. So the $4.9 million goes directly towards those 3 the acquisition costs and improvements.
Right.
Yeah.
Are you planning on taking the company public, or is that something that's in the strategy as well?
Absolutely. We do have plans to take the company public. We've announced a qualifying transaction with a TSX venture listed capital pool company where we will, where we aim to do a reverse takeover of that shell. That has been announced. The name of that shell is Discovery One Investments. It trades as the symbol DOIT. We hope to have a listing early next year with them.
Right. And last question, just for people out there that are sort of wondering, how you sort of move things forward. What's sort of the plan over the next couple of months? Is it a lot of raise the money and then trying to acquire the properties first and then go from there? Is that kind of the strategy?
Right. Well, right now we've got 3 locations on our plate. We're focusing on building out those locations and creating that brand of Pathfinder Camp Resorts. They'll all be branded the same. We'll have central booking systems. And once we've got those 2 operating early next year, actually one of them is currently operating right now through the winter. But once we've got those operating, then we plan to add 2 additional properties per year.
All right, there you go. Well, Joe, congratulations on this, and we look forward to hearing more about the company in the near future. Thanks very much for being with us.
Thanks, Steve.
All right, there's Joe Bleakley, the CEO and founder of Pacific Frontier Investments.